Okay, Mona, you said you had a problem with this tree.
I do. This tree was put in several years ago, Jeff. It's a Texas red oak, and as you can tell, it is just not thriving at all. So while you're here, I would really appreciate, let's take a look at it and see if we can find out what the problem might be and see if we can't get this tree thriving and growing like it should be.
Okay. I agree with you. Being in 5 years, it should have grown a lot more than this.
Yes.
And what I suspect, I don't see any evidence of fungus or insect damage like borers and that, so I suspect it has root problems. Mm-hmm. And trees won't grow if they have a root problem. So what we're going to do is dig it up. Let's get this out of here. We'll save your top rock to put back on a little later. Look how that tree rocks around in there.
Yes.
You see that? 5 years, you should not be able to do this. I almost think if I pulled up this tree, I could almost pull it right out of the ground.
I bet you can.
I bet I could.
I bet you can. Look at that.
Look at that. Been in the ground 5 years. I didn't even need the shovel.
No.
Look at. So let's look at this.
See what we have.
What is going on here? Now this isn't going to, look at these roots. Look at, they're all twisted.
Oh.
Going round and round and round. They're trying to undo themselves, but look, all the way up here. Look at that. Let's see if we can undo this. So this tree is slowly dying. It's strangling itself.
Will we be able to save it, do you think, Jeff?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, we'll give it a try.
It looks like it's still got a chance. All of these roots are completely twisted around in a circle. This is what I mean. Early on, these trees were never straightened out. So this tree was grown in a 1 gallon pot long time ago. Because this is about the size of a 1 gallon.
You can almost see exactly where the pot would
exactly.
be, can't you?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just amazing. When these roots get all bound up like that and twisted, mm-hmm. what's happening is it's not allowing nutrients that the roots pick up from the soil to move up to the plant.
To get through, right. Yeah. So it's been going just on minimal nutrients for the last 5 years.
Right. In the beginning, what you want to do is make sure whoever's planting your tree, don't just leave them on their own. You want to question them, you know, and if you can, you want to get out there and watch them plant the tree.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure they know what they're doing. It's doing pretty good. This also was planted here, so it's deeper.
Yes.
So that's not good. So this has been wet up to here. You don't want it any deeper than where these roots flare out. We're taking a hatchet. I mean, this seems like a real drastic thing because we've got roots that are so tight in up against this tree. And we're just trying to undo all this. This tree was probably doomed from the moment it sprouted because people didn't take care of it properly. Let me see here. Let's see about putting it back in. Now, see, we're not going to have to take much soil out of here to get this back in here because it was too deep to begin with. So, want to keep that up towards the surface. There they are. Let's just clip off some of these. This one now probably will require staking. I give it to the summer even.
Okay.
And see if it, how well it recovers.
We'll be running a check on it and see what it does.
But
it may be beyond helping.
Yeah. But I think we've given it everything we could.
That's good. And that's the important thing.
We're
giving it a chance and we'll see what happens.
Now we want to water it, make sure all the soil settles in, and hope for the best.
Okay.